Hello everyone in system, and this is FTB University. Hope everyone is well, having a amazing day. I myself, really good weekend. I had a good time with the daughter doing the trick-or-treating, all that jazz. Went to some haunted houses, and wore a lot of masks, because that is the life we live now. So, that is fun, that is good, and in between episodes, I did some mining. One thing I want to do right away, actually, let's go ahead and grab this. I also need to add a drawer to our tree farm. I realized I was one drawer short, so we'll have to do that. But I want to go ahead and make this gluttony charm. It's going to make our life a lot easier. We just need a golden apple here. Go ahead and grab that. I guess we should actually put it in the system so the system can see it. There we go. And this thing's just going to make it so we can eat food really quick. And it's just a quality life change. And it's really simple. So, yeah. What the heck just exploded? Wait, I am so confused. What just happened? What? What blew up, man? I have no idea. I'm very confused as to what just happened. Yeah, I don't know. Did I make a drawer? Let's run for our lives. We are chunk loaded, right? So I guess not chunk loaded, but chunk claimed, I should say. So nothing in our spawn chunks can blow up, mind you, but still no idea what blew up there. But I noticed this here, the sand in the output, that is from the hummus. When the hummus breaks down, so it only like grows so many trees or lasts so long, not sure exactly how it works. But you'll get an output of sand from the dirt will turn into, I guess the hummus will turn into sand, end up in the output, and that'll end up clogging up your system probably at some point. So I just need a drawer for it. But it's doing its thing, it's producing a good amount of charcoal, and a good amount of wood. We got 1500 wood, and this thing's only run for about an hour and a half since the last video, right? So haven't played that much at all, just did a little bit of mining, mostly to get a little bit more gold, and that is pretty good. Also, food. I got a new food here. Where is it at? Right there. These. I've been using those aubergine, and I got these stuffed ones now. Just takes beetroot, carrot, baked potato, and then you hook the aubergine, combine it together, and pretty good. Not wonderful, right? But not bad food at all, considering it's just all easy to get stuff that we already have. That's pretty awesome. And I'll just eat one now, right now, to show you how fast we can eat now. Just like that. And that's because of this, right? So the gluttony charm. This makes our life so much easier. Go ahead and put that stuff in there. We don't need it anymore or that. So first thing I want to get to today is going to be some extra utilities. We need to get into their power system, which is called grid power. It's kind of this weird kind of imaginary kind of power source, but we have to get to it. So let's go ahead and do it. Go ahead and grab a bunch of redstone torches. Let's just do something like that. Go ahead and grab. We already have those in our inventory, right? Some of this. We need some polished stone too. Polished stone is just bricks kind of combined together. Go ahead and put that in there. Then we need to grab these here. What are they called? Redstone gears. I think we actually need 9 of these total. So we'll just do that. Sweet. I guess we don't need any of them on us. Grab ourselves a manual mill. Go ahead and grab a resonator. And anything else we need there that I can think of? Oh, the rest of that polished stone. Let's go ahead and grab that. Sweet. And yeah, this is like a weird power source, only used within the mod. You can't power any other machines with it. It's just used for things from extra utilities. So that's kind of how it works there. I'm gonna need it to power these right away. I'd like to get to the Angel Ring. Probably not gonna get to that today, but that's a goal, right? This one is Creative Flight. But you can see there, it takes grid power, uses 32 GP. And that is what a GP is, a grid power, I should say. It is a GP. But they all take different amounts, right? So the first one we'll make will be the chicken ring. This one's really just like a slow fall type thing. And it takes 1 GP. I want to get to this one right away, the ring of the flying squid. This one's actually pretty solid. So this one gives you kind of a jetpack kind of style of flying. So short-term jetpack that just takes 60 GP to run. And we'd be kind of foolish not to make it. So that's going to be the one we go with there. But, oh, I haven't done anything yet. I'm supposed to be putting this in here. So what I do is put the stone bird in there. Here you go. Right-click this thing. It just kind of automatically starts right-clicking. Like, I can go in the inventory, so it just keeps hitting that, right? It keeps spinning. Every time it gets to 8 there, so you see the grid power is going from 1 to 8. When it hits 8, it actually produces a stone bird. So that's kind of how that works there. We need 6, and then we can kind of automate the creation of the stone bird. And then I don't have to worry about that anymore. Then we go work on our actual rings. We do have to make these golden lassos. These things pick up mobs. They're really cool. They pick up mobs, makes them portable. And we need to get some caught in these to be able to make the actual rings, right? So to get the squid one, we first need to make a chicken one, right? So we got to make the chicken wing ring, which is golden lasso with chicken. Then we got to grab a squid. And then, yeah, we can make that one. All these lassos actually take experience too. So yeah, they just use up a little bit of your experience to make here. We need one more, man. Give me one more, and then we go automate this puppy. And then, yeah, just go get the other stuff, right? Also, you need to make sure that this stuff is chunk loaded as well, because otherwise it will kind of stop working when you leave the chunks. Anyway, let's do that. Go ahead and will you go in the system? Stop the lag stuff. Do that. Go ahead, grab you. That's cool. Let's head upstairs. It is nighttime, so maybe we should sleep really quick. I'm still wondering what blew up. I have no idea what exploded. In between videos too, I guess on the weekend, I should say. I was fooling around in creative with that mod there. Maho Sukai. It's got some really cool stuff. Really, I don't know how useful a lot of it would be, but it's got some really cool stuff. Like, it is animated really well. I'm going to be getting into it pretty soon. We really need a Void Miner first, because it is a little expensive, I noticed. So, that's going to be something here. Anyway, let's do that. Sweet. Do we have water over here? I never grabbed buckets. We'll have to go grab some buckets really quick. Anyway, let's go ahead and do that there. Go ahead and grab this. That is good. Sweet. And like I said, we need a couple water buckets. So let's grab them real quick. And we might as well get our golden lassos as well. I'm going to go ahead and grab two of them. I don't think it uses the actual lasso in the creation of the ring. So we go ahead and do that. You see, I have 40 levels. Let's go ahead and grab that. Each one of those is going to take 8 levels out of me, because they take 8 levels to create. So, also, we got sirens in the background. But anyway, also, I need buckets, right? So let's go ahead and grab them. Go ahead and grab at least 2 of those puppies. Sweet. Awesome. You can create a infinite water source out there. I just did the thing, didn't I? Can we not do this right now? And go ahead and actually get some grid power being produced. These water mills just need water kind of flowing beside them. So, kind of like flowing water, right? So, not the source block. It wants a flowing piece, right? You see there, power generating 14 grid power. We can max that out by putting one in the opposite corner, because that'll give it 4 spaces on each side, which is just one away from the source block. That's kind of how you maximize power of these. I'll put another 3 here in a few minutes, but that polished stone that's in there right now should be automatically actually producing the stone burn now, so we don't even have to do anything. We should go into here though. I want to make sure this is all chunk loaded. Let's just do that. There you go. And that'll stay chunk loaded all the time. Now we need a squid and a chicken. So squid should be super easy. So let's head this way. Over here, there's usually squids all over the place over here. Hopefully we got one before too long. I see them here somewhere. There's one right over there. Let's go grab that buddy. Get him in here. Nothing special with these. Just right click on them and you got them, right? So let's jump in the water. Sweet. There we go. Got him. See there, it kind of changes. It looks like it's a fan when it has a mob in it. And then we need to hunt down a chicken. And that's probably over by our nature core. I seem to always have chickens over there. So let's go and check that one out. See if we can grab that. And then, yeah, finish off a few more of these watermills. And then have some kind of flight. You know what I mean? Just a little more mobility, right? So that is the idea. There you go. Got ourselves a chicken. And these ones too don't usually like being crafted inside of crafting systems. It does not like the MBT data usually, so I'm not even going to try, to be honest. So let's just head in here real quick. I'll just use the crafting tables that we have down here. Let's go ahead and toss you out of there. So the first one we need is the chicken wing ring. This one is literally just a slow fall. So let's go ahead and grab some iron. Do that. We need some feathers, which I believe I have in here somewhere. There's some of them. That's cool. Then what else do we do for that? Nothing. We got that one. So that's the chicken one. You can see there it says grid power. Actually uses a little bit of it, right? You also see over here that we're actually still producing stone burn, even though we're not over there anymore, which is really rad. Let's go ahead and grab 2 more of those watermills really quick. Let's put you in there. Sweet and sweet. Because once I make this next one, it's probably going to stop working, is what I'm thinking. Can you actually get in the system? That'd be great. What am I missing? Oh, my stone burn. What do you mean? Oh, it's being bizarre. Why does it do stuff like that? Let's go ahead and grab you. I don't like that it doesn't count the stuff in the grid as stuff in the inventory. That is really strange with the system there. And then the next one we need is the Ring of the Flying Squid, which I believe my ink sacks are in one of these. Yeah, right there. I guess I just need 4 of them. You can see how easy we can get squids right now. And then some diamonds. Let's go ahead and grab a couple of them. We still pretty much only have the diamonds we got from the first day of the video. Or I guess I should say the first video. We haven't really got any more at all whatsoever. But anyway, let's go ahead and pull that one out. See there, it doesn't actually use the lasso too. So we'll be able to use that for other stuff. Guess we just need a ender pearl. So let's get a ender. Sweet, we got one right there. That's cool. And then flying squid, right? No, down here, flying squid. There we go. So we have this now. Now it probably doesn't have enough word power to work right now. You can see right there, it says 19 of 16. We're not producing enough. This ring takes 16 itself. So that resonator down there is actually already stopped. But we have a couple more water mills here, right? So we can fix that really quickly. Go ahead and grab these two right here. Put one here, put one there. Oh, I didn't actually, I meant to do this. Let's fix this really quick. There we go. We actually need the infinite water source so we can get this thing fully set up. Let's bring that one and then that one. Sweet. Let's just put one there. And can you get out of there? That'd be great. Sweet. Then we can just do this, right? Awesome. So once I do this, we should already have enough power, I think. No, we're only at 14 right now. When I put that center one there, we should be good. There we go. We're up to 44, which is awesome. And then we just need to add a couple more buckets. And once I have four of them in here, it'll actually be at 64 grid power just with this little setup here. I basically just need one here and one here. One bucket of water here and one more water mill. That'll be 64 grid power. But we're already at 48, which is awesome. And then we can actually wear our ring now. So let's go ahead and wear it. You can see there, you got a little bar that's over my hearts. That is like a jetpack, right? So it's kind of like a jetpack. If I let go, it goes up. You know what I mean? Kind of hover, move around. And we got mobility. We got a mobility now. Nothing will stay, should anyway, stay forever chunk loaded. And this thing should always work and just always recharge, right? And then I just have mobility. So that is the idea. So that is pretty cool. And I guess we just need one more water mill. And then we're done this, man. We're already moved on. Look at this. Let's eat food fast. Here we go. Got that. And I guess we just need the stuff in there, right? That and that. Did that actually go in there? Get out of there. Sweet. Awesome. And then done. It would be 64, man. After this, I think we may head to the Nether. I'd like to hunt down blaze rods. I really need blaze rods. That is something I need. I also need some drops of evil. So drops of evil are going to be good for a mob farm, but they're going to be also good for, I believe, this cursed lasso. Yeah, to be able to get the angel ring, which is going to give us the rate of flight. You need this one to be able to catch a ghast, I believe, is what you need. If you actually go to the angel ring, yeah, you need a ghast in it. You have to have these cursed ones to be able to catch aggressive mobs, right? So that is the thing. And then we need a bat as well, but I'm not expecting to get to this today. I'm just kind of getting set up in that direction. So, okay, I went ahead and got myself over to the Nether here. I also made myself a set of armor. So I'm actually wearing a full set of the dark armor now, which is pretty cool. These ones can be upgraded. So this is the pair we found. We found this one in the city. It actually has some upgrades on it. It has jump and some empowered and some other stuff. These ones here have no kind of upgrades on them yet. I just made them. So it has possible upgrades. So lots of stuff can go on them. They'll be really good later on. I just needed some armor for when we are in the Nether, right? So that is cool. Also, I went ahead and grabbed this. This is a soul bead. We got this the first time we were here. I'm going to go ahead and grab that with a couple pieces of soul sand. We're going to get this item, soul powder. This is supposed to work like an Eye of Ender. So I've never used one before, but we're definitely going to try that out. Let's head over here a little bit. There we go. Head this way. Also made myself the sword, the Ender. This is from the same mod. It's another weapon we can upgrade later on quite a bit, actually. Possible upgrades, micro, anvil, empowered, stuff like that. Gets more damage, which is pretty cool. But also gives you more enderpearl drops. So yeah, this stuff's all dark steel. We already. No, we already done that before, so nothing new there. I want to stay away from that thing. That thing is a blaze spawner, but you can see where it is. It's actually really difficult to deal with, so I don't want to go there. I just want to go over here somewhere. Then we're going to use this dust, I guess. And this thing should indicate, so if I actually use this, which way a fortress is. So let's actually use that. There we go. Oh, looks like it's that-ish way. Oh, I don't want to go near that pillar at all, actually. So it looks like it's up a bit. Maybe it isn't up. Actually, I'm curious too. Is it going to drop like an Eye of Ender? No, it didn't look like a drop. Maybe it's a chance thing. But either way, it shows us the rough direction we need to head. So that is cool. Let's head over here. Awesome. What is that explosion? Oh, we're getting blown up by a ghast, I think, but not too worried about that. Let's just head this way. I'd like to find some more of those ghosts, actually, if we could. If we could find some more of those ghosts. we can make more of those powders and kind of lock down exactly where this fortress is, because that'd be nice all around, actually. So anyway, we'll head this way, because it looked like it was roughly in this direction. And we should stay lower so we could see it. The fog that's here is a little rough, I have to say, for kind of figuring out where you're at. But anyway, I do have my portal kind of set there, so I can actually find it really easy. I'm not seeing any of those ghosts right now, which I was kind of hoping for, to be honest. Just so we could hunt it down really easy. I guess we're going to go up this way. Loving this squid. This squid jetpack is making our life so much easier all around, actually. Is that? I think I just saw a critter I don't really like. These guys are nasty. These things are thongcraft, aren't they? Ugh. Yeah, I think they're thongcraft. They're nasty. They electrocute. Oh, there's one of those guys. Maybe he'll drop me a bead. Give me a bead, buddy. You give me a bead, maybe I can hunt this down a little more. Ugh. There we go. Did we get one? Oh, we did too. Awesome. Let's go ahead and make another one of those. There we go. See if we can hunt down this fortress, man. This place is pretty rad. Don't walk towards me. It makes me think you're being aggressive. There we go. So which way is it this way? Wait. Did I just get robbed because you were here? Did it really just stop that from doing its thing? I think it did too. That's miserable. Might be that way. I'm going to look around for a bit. See if I can find some more of those ghosts. See if we're going to hunt down exactly where this fortress is at. Okay, I found myself another fortress, and we're not looking too bad here. It's actually not that far away. It was about, 300 meters that way. Oh, we got one of them. Let's go ahead and swap here. Probably a good idea. Here we go. Got another blaze rod. What do we got down here? Just a fiery death? We'll go see if there's any rooms down here. But the main thing I'm looking for while I'm here is some blaze rods. So I already have two of those, so it isn't too bad. The eating food fast is actually very helpful, I have to say, which is cool. Looks like this is like a dead end. Nothing down here. I may grab that quartz, though. That looks like a pretty good patch. Go ahead and get that. And I'm really hoping there's a spawner around here, actually. If I could find a blaze spawner, then I'll just have a nice dedicated area I know I can come to and find more of this. So that is awesome. Also ran into another one of those wraiths, actually, but already found the fortress anyway, so that's a thing. Didn't need the bead. It just kind of, I think, hunts down the nearest fortress, so if I use it here, it's just going to find this one anyway, so that's not that useful. I don't like these things. They always hit me, and then I'm on fire and confused. Oh, there's a blaze spawner there. What's over this way, though? Let's look really quick. I don't think this is very much of a fortress. Oh, there you go. That's something I need. These guys have a 10% chance of dropping the drops of evil that I need, but it's literally 10%. Also, it's weird jumping with the squid ring, so it's hard to do my crits. Go away. There you go. Got those guys. That's cool. There's another one over there. But drop of evil. I want to make sure that's still 10%. Yeah, it's 10%, so that isn't too bad. Got you over there. Can you come over this way so I don't get lit on fire? Can you not see me? What's your problem, buddy? What's your problem? Yeah. Go away. There we go. That's cool. Doing the fighting. I'm going to need to have some material, I guess, to lock that in, too. That spawner. Because otherwise, I'm just going to get cooked, right? And getting cooked isn't really what I came here for. I was hoping for a chest. Because you can, a lot of times in these fortresses, you can find the lava charms. And the lava charm would be really good for the nether, actually. Just to make sure we hit lava. You have like a 10-second kind of buffer, I believe. Before you actually start taking damage, right? So it'd be really nice to have one of those. But this fortress doesn't seem to have a lot to it. But anyway, so now deal with that. Oh, that's not right. I'm going to get cooked here in a second. There you go. Let's eat some food. Sweet. I don't think torches really matter with these things, do they? They can spawn in anything but like direct like sunlight, right? I think that's how it works. Anyway, let's do something like this for right now. Kind of keep it a little controlled. Then we're going to have to make ourselves a little room here, apparently. Because these other guys want to light me on fire. I'm placing torches all over the place. I don't know why I'm holding these here. That was when I was mining obsidian. Anyway, let's go this way. That's cool. Awesome. I don't even know where I got shot from now. Wait, what? Oh, I see the spawner. I thought I could see the spawner. It wasn't covered anymore. That was weird, actually. What was that? I want to look at that again. Oh, you can actually see when it disables. I can see that it's not working right now. That is actually really cool. Is that a normal? I don't think that's a normal thing, isn't it? That is actually really strange. I feel like I should have a door here. Anyway, let's do this. Let's make ourselves a little tunnel, I guess. Then I can just kind of walk in, hit them a few times, back out and heal. And just get us a few of these, right? And then I'll have to fight some more of the actual wither skeletons. So I'll have to wander around here for a bit. Nothing I can do about that. But at least I found the resources we need, right? So we have everything we need. And I can actually get into enchantment tables and stuff like that, right? So that is one of my limitations I had. I don't like these guys. They're so hard to hit, too. I don't know if they drop anything. I haven't seen any of them drop anything yet. No, we got another area down here, actually. Anything here, or is it going to be a dead-end roof? Looks like a dead-end roof. Oh, no, we got more stuff, man. We got more fortress. Might get lucky down here. Yeah, see that? See how I just dodged your fireball, buddy? You're probably going to hit me this time, but that's fine. There we go. Look at this. We got some more fortress. Oh, a second spawner. Oh, nice. Let's get rid of that guy. I may actually break this one. So let's actually break this one. There we go. Let's kill you. Because I don't like you. And we'll be able to use that to set up a mob farm at some point, right? Because we have Ender IO. We have a blaze spawner now. That is literally all we need for that. So that's cool. And yeah, maybe I'll just look around a little more. See if I actually find anything. And if not, I'm just going to hunt down a bunch of wither skeletons and hit them until I get enough drops of evil. I need two. I have to say, this is one of the saddest little nether fortresses I've ever run into. I'm just not seeing much of anything we need. So it's kind of just a sad little fortress of sadness. So that's a thing. Also, those little wraith guys don't have any knockback, but that isn't what's really odd about them. What's really odd about those little wraith guys is that some of them sound like cats and some of them sound like dogs. And I killed one and gave me a zombie head. So they have identity issues, is basically what I'm trying to say. I have no idea what's going on with the little wraith guys. They're definitely doing some weird stuff. Where's this one wither skeleton? I've been just hunting these guys down and having no luck at all. He must be at the bottom of the stairs again, right? You chilling down here? Yeah, come on up. I just need two of these drops of evil. So I'm basically stuck in this area until I either run out of food or get two drops of evil. Because, yeah, I'm not getting it, man. I'm not getting it at all. I haven't got one yet. I just some wither ash and wither dust. And a decent amount of blaze rods as well. So that isn't bad, but you know what I mean? I'm just grinding it out. Grinding it out. And once I got them, I got them. What is going on here? Is there some kind of pigman party? Some kind of ritual here I was not invited to? Why is there so many of them? Either way, I'm going to run around here for a bit, try to hunt this down, get us some drops of evil, then we'll head back to the overworld, I hope. Hopefully it doesn't take too long, but you can see they're just, if you look at the radar there, there's nothing around here. Oh, this one's a cow. So this one here, it's a cow. Yeah. What are they supposed to be, like the souls of like undead animals? It's really, really creepy, actually. Is that another fortress? We have another fortress right over here. Is this going to be a not-so-sad one? Because that would be great. This one is so sad. Oh, I didn't even see this over here. Look at this. We got another fortress. It's our Christmas over here. Maybe this one actually has some skeletons in it. I see a blaze. Oh, I want to deal with the skeleton first. If I could. Yeah, right in the head. Come down. Yeah. So yeah, hopefully this one's better. It was nice that two of them were that close to each other. That's cool. Did not get what I wanted, but either way, it's more options, right? Oh, and I'm getting cooked. Stop cooking me. So far, this fortress here isn't much better. Still not seeing a lot of stuff, but we finally got a chest here. Oh, we got two chests. Let's see here. Affinity bimetals. Oh, we'll take the bee. Take some saddles. Got a capacitor. Yeah, we got some stuff here, finally. Finally, we got something. More bimetal gears. These are for the second level machines, right? Yeah, the second level ones. Oh, a lava charm. That's awesome. So I could wear that and not... Where do I have to wear that one? It's a ring as well. That's unfortunate. I have two rings. Oh, we can wear two rings. So now if I fall in lava, I won't actually, you know, instantly die. You know what I mean? Not that you instantly die, but it feels like it sometimes, right? A dead end here. But that is a big find right there, right? So I have 10 seconds. You can see there, it's above my armor. 10 seconds where I can sit in lava and not die, basically, which is pretty awesome. And apparently there is a skeleton over here. Are you on the roof? Oh, no, there's two of them right there. Let's go ahead and deal with these. Give me a drop of evil. Give me two drops of evil, actually. I'm having pretty bad luck, actually. This is like the 12th or 13th one I've killed. And it's 10%, so it's RNG based, but I'd like to just get them and be done with this place. Totem are returning. I don't know what that is. I'm going to grab those and some more bimetal gears. I'm going to grab all this iridium too, because we do have IC2 in the pack. And that would be good to start off on that mod. So anyway, pretty cool. Finding some stuff now, at least. I'm just not, living in despair. Might as well grab these boots too. Look at that. These runes, all they do is recolor. That's just 10. That's that. Recolor enchants on weapons. So if you enchant a sword and want to recolor the look of it, you can do that. But it's not that special. And lots of these gears, though. Another capacitor. What's this one? Energy buffer, energy intake. Huh. That's a machine. Increases storage speed. Oh, this one's for the sag mill. But it's not that great, actually. So anyway, finding some stuff either way. Good thing we have lots of kind of inventory to just save all the stuff really easy. Let's do something like that. Go ahead and grab this other junk. There we go. Have no idea what this totem of returning is, but I'm sure we'll figure it out at some point. Oh, another blaze spawner. Look at this. Look at that. Another blaze spawner. Might as well grab that. There you go. I can change that to a different kind of spawner later on, right? So it doesn't even matter if we only need one. We'll have one that we can switch to something else. So that is cool. Grab that puppy. And this second fortress is actually pretty solid all around, actually. Oh, we got another spawner. Look at this. Look at this. Spawners all around. Spawners for everyone. Although spawners aren't hard to find in this pack. Like, ooh. Let's take a walk. There you go. a little too much for me. But, yeah, they're not hard to find in this pack. Pretty much because you can find those buildings in the above world with the zombie spawners and the witch spawners in it. So, it's not too bad. Oh, you gonna be him? You gonna be the one? Huh? You gonna be the one? Like 20 later? Oh, we got it. We got it. We got our drop of fuel. Finally. That's been like 20 of them. 20 of them to get one. I'm gonna keep going. And, we got another one right here. We got two more. Look at this. This is a lucky place. Every time I find them, though, there's always a blaze right nearby just being a jerk. Just being a jerk. Making my life more difficult. Anyway. Nope. No luck there. Where are you going? You're going the wrong way, buddy. Yeah. You running away? Did we get it? No. Aw. Are you going to be the last one? Oh, we got two. We got two drops of evil now. We're good. We got it. We got 20 blaze rods, two drops of evil, tons of other stuff. I can actually get out of this dimension now. Awesome. I was getting kind of burned out here. I've actually spent already about a half an hour here, and I was having no luck. It usually doesn't take me this long at all. I just, my luck is just run dry. Anyway, I'm going to head home, and then, yeah, maybe we'll do some enchanting and stuff, because the enchanting system in this is supposed to be actually pretty neat. So, yeah, just get the heck out of here. And we got one of those fire bats. Take that, fire bat. No, take that. No, take that. There. Fire bat took something. Okay, we're finally back from the nether. So the main thing I wanted to do was this here. I want to go ahead and turn this into a cursed lasso. And this is going to be the way we're able to get the last mob we need, I guess. It's going to be for the, we still need two. We won't get them today, like I said. But we need a ghast and a bat. Bat should be too hard. Just go down, cave, and grab him. Find one, grab it, put him in there. So that's good. So I'll be able to do that with the other golden lasso that we have. So that's good. So I have this one. And this one's going to be for a ghast. I can't remember if the ghast has to be hurt. I think it has to be hurt when you put it inside the cursed lasso. So I think that's how it works. I don't know. I think it just has to have lower hit points. I can't remember. I know at one point it was one hit point. It had to be at one hit point. I don't know if it's still one hit point. So, yeah, I'm not sure. But I think we have to hurt it. So I think that's a thing. But the other thing I wanted to try, actually, was just a enchantment table. Because, it has a different way of doing things than most packs. So let's go ahead and take that. Go ahead and grab that. Grab an enchantment table, right? And I just want to take that and pop it down and take a look-see. So it has a completely different interface here. So let's look at that. Let's go grab some lapis. There we go. Go ahead and get a stack. I haven't actually seen a lot of lapis yet, to be honest. But anyway, let's pop that in there. And it's got a little bar over here. That's kind of weird. Let's go ahead and put that there. And it wants a level. If we hit a level, we get a Tetris piece. So we can put smite on it. I don't know how this works. That took another level. Insight. I'm not sure what insight is. Oh, you can right click to rotate it. So you actually play Tetris. That is actually kind of neat. That? Can I grab another one? And knockback, but I don't want knockback. I guess you can only put three a chance on with no bookcases. We're probably limited by bookcases right now, but that's fine. That's actually pretty cool. And if I take that out, it'll get all that stuff. So I'll get knockback, insight, and smite. That's actually kind of neat how that works, right? So in theory, if you had the right shape, you could probably fit one more in there, but every enchantment is going to have a different shape. That's actually very neat. That's actually really cool. I can just right click to move it, right? So I could go, and then I could fit a different shape in here. Then I could actually, what is that? Right click. There you go. Right click. Get it up on top instead. Yeah. Look at that. Then I'd be able to fit a different shape down here. So that's actually really neat. I like the way that works. That is kind of cool. I've never seen anything like that. And I think this is just a Quark version, right? I think this is from Quark anyway. I've never used the Quark enchantment table before. So it's a completely different way of handling things, I have to say. We do have the Ender IO one in here, but this is still neat. I like this. This is actually really cool. I like that. That's kind of neat. I'm going to take the enchantments either way. Let's go ahead and do that. At least we have something on here. We have some smite. Insight, I think, is extra experience. That's what I think it is. Can we actually just pull up insight? Take a look. Do that. Left shift. Increases experience gain when using the item. Okay, so just extra experience probably from killing mobs. So that is cool. And yeah, that is pretty awesome. That is actually not bad at all. That is cool. I know I'm saying that a lot, but at the same time, it's actually pretty rad. So I'm not sure either. We need to find a way to repair tools, and I haven't found one yet. So I'm going to have to figure that out, because I'm going to want to be able to keep our Ender and all this armor, right? So I'm going to have to go through the mods and see what we have access to. But that is pretty cool all around. And if I go to prefab now, I think I could actually get some better ones, right? This is one I'm probably going to do in between episodes. I'm going to go ahead and graph this up. Then we could just drop it tomorrow. But I needed a bunch of blaze rods, right? I needed it for the brewing stands, the bookshelves. I guess the bookshelves, I could just go rob that village. And then anything else there that was very special? Nothing else was too special. Just needed to make some of those cool as the lanterns. Get that done. And nothing else advanced really interests me. So, okay, I think I'm going to go ahead and wrap this one up here. But that is kind of cool. I just noticed that. I put my tool in there. Look at that. That is actually kind of neat how that works. It kind of swings it around, animates it a little bit. I actually really like that. It's just weird that you have to pay experience to be able to see what you can get. That's the only thing that is really weird about that. But I'm going to go ahead and wrap this one up here. As always, if you guys like this video, please hit that like button. If you really liked it, hit that subscribe button. It is always appreciated. Well, you guys all have a good one. See you guys next video. Later.